some peace tonight.
A bill to mandate that non-abstinence-based sexual education be offered in school. The people of the state of Michigan enact Section 1. Non-abstinence-based sexual education is to be offered in every publicly funded high school. Section 2. This bill will be funded by the school to the regular health teacher or teacher with the ability to teach sexual education. Section 3. A parental consent form must be sent home at the beginning of the sexual education session so the parent or guardian of the student is aware of what the student will be taught. Section 4, an abstinence-based program will be offered for parents who disagree. Section 5, an abstinence plus or non-abstinence-based sexual education. Students are to be acknowledged that many teenagers will become sexually active. Students will learn about contraception and condom use, and discussions about abortions and sexually transmitted diseases will occur. Section 6, once a year, the sexual education class is to be evaluated by the board of the school district. Section 7, if the school district is not providing non-abstinence-based sexual education, they'll be fined $5,000 per inspection. Section 8, the Michigan Department of Education will enforce this law. Section 9, this bill will go into effect at the beginning of the next school year after passage.
So, how do you think that this bill will affect you in schools statewide?
Well, it's like schools at other states that have non-abstinence-based sexual education, there's a big difference between teenage pregnancies. So I found some statistics from 2011, and I tried to find a state that had a similar population to Michigan, and I found Virginia, who has non-abstinence-based sexual education, and their pregnancies under 20 years old are only 6,581 in the year of 2011 versus 9,752 in Michigan.
Why did you write this bill?
I'm actually in a program at my school called Youth in Government, and it's through the YMCA, and we go to Lansing for 4 days in April, and we debate our bills in the actual House and Senate, and it's a lot of fun. And my bill last year, this is my bill from last year, it actually passed all the way through the program, so the youth governor approved it, and now it's going to eventually be in the actual Michigan government, which is pretty cool.
Good morning, West Ottawa. What's going on today? We know, but you don't, so let's get you the latest news. I'm Audrey.
I'm Julia. Let's get the show started. Prom is on the way. If you are a freshman or are 12, this information is irrelevant because you're not going to get asked anyways. Otherwise, save the date for Saturday, May 16th.
Scholarship of the week, Elise Joy France Scholarship. Seniors who have a cumulative GPA of a 3.0 or higher and interest in government, civics, economics, or social studies qualify to apply.
The deadline is April 15th. For more information, visit the Hot Scholarship list at listottawa.net. Looks like Audrey has a video for us about boys lacrosse. Let's check it out.
There are a lot of sports here at West Ottawa, one of which is boys lacrosse. At this time, they are trying out for either JV or varsity. I asked two people on the team about the sport. Brandon Bold, who's a sophomore, and Alex Turner, a freshman.
I am close defense, which means I get the 6-foot deep hole, which is quite fun. I have high hopes for us because the returning sophomores are very good, and I see a lot of potential in the incoming freshmen.
What do you love most about being a part of the West Ottawa lacrosse team?
It's lacrosse, which is the best spring sport ever. No debate. My passes, they're absolutely amazing.
I think the most important thing, I think, for our team is to work more as a team and trust each other in our abilities to play.
We hope to look forward to a great season this year with boys lacrosse. Holland is getting heated, and that means it's time to start dressing for the warm weather. Make sure your legs aren't too scandalous and keep your shoulders out of view.
All seniors need to sign up for Jungle, which is actually not in a real jungle, much to the disbelief of many. The cost is $60, however, scholarships are available for those who need it. If you miss this, you will regret it. Julia has a video for us about comprehensive sexual education. Let's take a look.
A bill to mandate that non-abstinence-based sexual education be offered in school. The people of the state of Michigan enact Section 1, non-abstinence-based sexual education is to be offered in every publicly funded high school. Section 2, this bill will be funded by the school to the regular health teacher or teacher with the ability to teach sexual education. Section 3, a parental consent form must be sent home at the beginning of the sexual education session so the parent or guardian of the student is aware what the student will be taught. Section 4, an abstinence-based program will be offered for parents who disagree. Section 5, an abstinence plus or non-abstinence-based sexual education. Students are to be acknowledged that many teenagers will become sexually active. Students will learn about contraception and condom use, and discussions about abortions and sexually transmitted diseases will occur. Section 6, once a year, the sexual education class is to be evaluated by the board of the school district. Section 7, if the school district is not providing non-abstinence-based sexual education, they'll be fined $5,000 per inspection. Section 8, the Michigan Department of Education will enforce this law. Section 9, this bill will go into effect at the beginning of the next school year after passage.
So, how do you think that this bill will affect you in schools statewide?
Well, it's like schools at other states that have non-abstinence-based sexual education, there's a big difference between teenage pregnancies. So I found some statistics from 2011, and I tried to find a state that had a similar population to Michigan, and I found Virginia, who has non-abstinence-based sexual education, and their pregnancies under 20 years old are only 6,581 in the year of 2011 versus 9,752 in Michigan.
Why did you write this bill, and what was the
I'm actually in a program at my school called Youth and Government, and it's through the YMCA, and we go to Lansing for 4 days in April, and we debate our bills in the actual House and Senate, and it's a lot of fun. And my bill last year, this is my bill from last year, it actually passed all the way through the program, so the youth governor approved it, and now it's going to eventually be in the actual Michigan government, which is pretty cool.
Auditions for the Theater Caravan production, The Invention, will be held Monday and Tuesday, April 13 and 14, from 3 to 4:15 in the LGI room. Students will be reading selections from the script during the audition. Anyone wanting to borrow a script may check one out from Mr. Foley. See Mr. Foley if you have any questions.
Calling all juniors, your ACT and work keys are behind you, and now it's time to start thinking about your senior year. You are invited to join a group of like-minded classmates for a junior meeting.
Please check your West Ottawa email for the date, time, and place for this meeting. If you are unable to meet at your assigned time, please check with your counselor to get this helpful information.
You will also be given a pass prior to the meeting so that your attendance may be verified. You're not going to succeed in getting out of this. We hope that you will find this to be a valuable opportunity to start thinking about next year.
We need help getting clothes for the WOCC. You can drop off your clothes at either building's receptionist desk. If you have any questions, contact Salvador Gutierrez, Priscilla Acevedo, Madison S., or find the book room at South on any seminar day.
Seniors, be sure to bring in those acceptance letters to Mrs. Hausler in the front office as soon as possible so you can hear your name in the ceiling. Make sure you're getting good grades in your classes because summer is in 2 months, and if you don't step it up right now, you could be spending your summer here.
If you need help with your classes, you should contact your teachers to help in seminar or contact someone in the library. Well, looks like your time has been sufficiently used.
All right, until next time, farewell.
Drink and drive.